So let's talk about the system of ducts that you have in the male reproductive system. And these are really going to play a role in terms of the transport of certain fluids. Two in specific that we'll talk about is semen. And semen is going to be composed of various fluids, seminal fluid, some other fluids that we'll discuss, as well as semen. But before we get into the specifics of the certain types of ducts, I want to note that ducts are going to have varying amounts of smooth muscle. And this smooth muscle will contract in order for the flow of these particular types of materials to the external portion of the urethral orifice. So we'll start with the ducts that are associated internally in terms of the testes. And you can see here what we refer to as the epididymis. This is kind of this coalescing of the more internal structures of the testes. And those more internal structures are going to be the seminiferous tubules. And we discussed this in a little bit of detail earlier. This is where spermatogenesis occurs, so the actual formation of the sperm. Those seminiferous tubules will kind of coalesce into these fairly small and short straight tubules, which will continue on into what we refer to as the direct testes, into these efferent ducts, which will eventually form into what we refer to as the ductus epididymis. And that's really just a portion of the larger epididymis. So if you see here, you see some of these small efferent ductules that look like they're kind of external to the testes because they're kind of coalescing into this comma-shaped epididymis in this region. Now, so as you have this kind of tube that's going to have the newly formed sperm, this epididymis is going to continue on as the tail. And once you get to kind of an expansion in this region of this distal portion, the name changes to the ductus deferens. And sometimes you hear this referred to as the vas deferens. Now, this is going to have sperm within it, and inside this area, you can have sperm maturation occur in this region. Now, sperm can actually be stored within the epididymis. It can be stored for upwards of a month or a little bit longer. And then if certain innervation or sexual arousal occurs, this can lead to ejaculation and the movement of the sperm from here through the ductus deferens, eventually into the urethral portion. All right, so let's continue with the ductus deferens. So we've had that dilated portion of the epididymis. You have the name change to the ductus deferens. This is going to travel within the spermatic cord, which is within the scrotum. The spermatic cord, as we know, is going to travel through the inguinal canal. So now we're internal, so we're talking about internal organs or associated internal organs, such as the ureter. So it's going to go over the ureter. And then eventually it will end up in what we refer to as the ampulla of the ductus deferens. So it's this dilated, most distal portion, or you can refer to it as the most proximal portion, depending on which way you want to think about it, of that ductus deferens. And so what it will do, so here's your ductus deferens, here's that dilated portion, and it's going to meet up with the duct in terms of the seminal vesicle. And so where those two ducts meet up, so the duct of the seminal vesicle, which is one of those secondary sex organs. So where the duct of the seminal vesicle meets up with the ampulla of the ductus deferens, that's going to be referred to as the ejaculatory duct. So if we're looking at this particular illustration right here, you had the bladder here. This is the prostate. And this is actually where, in this small region right here, where you're going to have the depositing of this seminal fluid into this region. So it's going to be deposited into what we refer to as the prostatic urethra, and then you'll have the continuation and the movement of this fluid throughout the entirety of the urethra. So we will continue our discussion of these ducts, and we'll talk a bit more in terms of what is going to be the composition of some of these secondary sexual organs in terms of the fluids that are secreted.